this session we are going to see how to work with the images in OAF page and how to display the images in the page, how to create a region and how to create items and how to work with the CO and what are the components of CO. Let's start. I have a few notes here, like the session agenda. So it's going to be like displaying the images and creating items and regions in the page, and how to display the values using page context and working with the controller. Okay, let's start. So before we start, just a recap. In previous session we have seen how to install a JDeveloper, how to configure a JDeveloper to develop an OAF page. Now in this session we are going to create a new page quickly, and we are going to work with that page. Okay, so to create a page, click on applications, new OAF workspace. Then we will take this workspace as session 2. Click on OK. Then I'm going to give the project name as session 2 project, and then default package will be info.oracle.apps.po.session.prj.web.ui. Click on next, then use the database connection. Okay, and runtime connection will be the username will be the operations and password and application short name, and responsibility key is purchasing operations. Okay, next, finish. Yeah, now we have created a workspace and project. The next thing is we will have to create one AM, and we need to attach that AM to the page. Next, let's create a AM. To create an AM, so the project, and click on resources, then right click. Then click on new application module. Next, so for application module, the structure of the package should be like server. Instead of web UI, it comes as a server, and this application module AM will be session AM. So instead of session AM, we will take new session AM. Next, and generate Java files. Next, finish. Yeah, we have created a AM. Now we need to create a page. Again, right click on resources. Click on new, OAF components, page. Okay, and this page will be like new session page, and the package should be like what we have given in the while creating a project. Okay, yeah, we have created a page also. Now let's expand this application sources, and here info Oracle. Then here it is going to be a session project and web UI new session page that what we have created. So whenever we click on the page.xml which we have created, so we can see the page structure in structure navigation in below pan. Okay, so here if you see, there is one default region which is created and along with the corporate branding and image. Okay, so let's attach AM to this page. Here select the AM which we have created. So we have created session AM, right? So new session AM. New session AM, select the new session AM. Give the window title as new session. Then the title as my page. Or instead of window title new session, we'll take a new page and my page. Okay, so now let's run this page and see. It is compiling. It is taking some time. Yeah, it's compiled successfully and there is no errors. We can see here. it's starting OSU4J server. Yeah, page is open and we have created a page successfully. Now what we are going to do is, the first step we are going to see how to change this logo. Okay, so many of the clients they may change the logo once they install, once they implement the Oracle applications. So now let's see like how this branding logo can be changed. Okay, so here what we have to do is, in page structure you can see the page layout components. In page layout components you can see the corporate branding image. Okay, if you click on corporate branding image, in property inspector you can see the item style is a image and the item URI is OA Media FND SS Corp dot GIF. Okay, so this is the image which is being displayed when page is run. Okay, now if we want to change that image, what we have to do is, we will have to move our image to the OA Media folder, then we need to give that image name here. Okay, so in local machine the OA Media folder is in where we extracted the Java patch. Go to Java, then JDEV home, JDEV. Here my HTML and OA Media. Basically this is the place where we keep all the images which is opening in the pages. This is in the local system, and this is if you are placing the image here, that is enough to display when we run the page. But in server all images will be there in OA Media. So let's see like the path which we keep the images. And then login. Okay, cd dollar OA underscore media. So if you see, this is the path like this images will be there in application top, common Java, classes or collapse media folder. So if you see, if you give an ls, we can see all the list of the images which is there in this folder, ls minus ldr. Yeah, so like these are all the images which is being used in Oracle Apps. Okay, so for now what we are doing is, we are going to change this image in a local system, and we are going to see. So now we are not going to see how to upload into the server. So at the end of the, like maybe in a different session, I am going to explain like the developed page, how to upload to the server. Okay, so now let's change this image. This is the folder where we'll have the images, and here we have few images. Like we are going to change the Oracle logo to the just a simple logo. logo.jpg. And this is what how logo dot jpg. Okay, and now let's see, we run the page and see. After this, we are going to see how to insert an image in the page. Yeah, so it is showing an internal server. Let's run again. Yeah, we have successfully changed the logo and we have replaced with the Oracle logo. And now let's see how to display a image in the page. Okay, so this is something like the existing logo, we have changed it. And if we want to display any image in the page, how we can display? Okay, let's open the JDeveloper. And under this region, okay, right click new item. Okay, so we have taken new item and region 1 and item 1. So go to the property inspector, and here we can see item style. So this item style we need to change it to the image. Okay, and once we change that item style to image, we'll have to give the image URI. Okay, I am going to give the same URI, and I'm going to display the same image, OA_media logo dot jpg. Yeah, we have created an item, and we change the item type, item style to image. Then in image URI we have changed, we have given the logo path. Okay, and the prompt we can give like we can give page image. Okay, so let's run this. And we'll see. Now page is going to open. Yeah, if you see like the logo is being changed as well as the we have inserted a image in the page. Okay, now we are done with the first thing, like displaying images in the page. Now we are going to see how to create a region and items under a region. Okay, so to create a region, so what we have to do is under the main region we'll have to click and create a new and then select region. So here we have the ID will be region 2 and the region style will be like we have different region styles here. If you see like advanced search, advanced table and cell format, table format, flow layout and graph table, and so all those things. So it is very difficult to discuss about all these things. Let's see about message component layout. Okay, so we have created a region with the message component layout. Okay, so now what we are going to do is under this particular region, so we are going to create the items. Yeah. To create an item under a particular region, just right click and new message text input. Yep, this is item 2 and the item style is message text input. Here, so what we do is the prompt we will take as a user ID, and let's create one more item. New message text input. And this is item 3 and same message text input, and prompt we give username, and let's create one more item, this is text input, and prompt responsibility ID, and let's create one more item, responsibility name. Yeah, so we have created a new region, and under the new region we have created 4 items. Okay, so let's run this page and we see like how this layout region is looks like and how the items is going to be displayed. It's still compiling. Yeah, it's compiled and going to open the page. Yeah, now we are good and the page is open. If you see here we have taken 4 items. That 4 items we have given a prompt as user ID, username, responsibility ID and responsibility name. Okay, so how to display the values here, whatever the user, like whoever is the user which is logged in, and the username of the login, and responsibility ID and responsibility name. For this, what we have to do is we'll have to create one controller. To create a controller, what so in main page structure, main region, so right click and set controller. If we create a controller under a child region, so that life of that controller will be restricted to that particular region. So we are going to create a control under a head region, okay? And this controller I am going to take session, new session, and new session CO. Region and set new controller here. So we need to remove one web UI, and the name we are going to give new session CO. Yeah, once we create a controller, we can see the file which is generated. So that is new session co.java, and in here you can see the code, Java code. If you see, like, there is a class which is created, new session co, and with extend method like OAF controller impl. Okay, so basically co will have two main things, that is two methods. One is process request, and second one is process form request. Okay, so when these two methods is being used, means process request is being used when the page is loading, I mean, like, before the page is loading, if we want to do something, like if you want to file some code, so then the code will be written in the process request. And when this when we write a code in process form request, is something like there is a page which is already opened, and there is a button. So whenever we click on that particular button, if we want to do something, like if you want to display something, when we click on that button, if you want to display something on below, or something like if you want to take any like business action, so like we are going to write a code in process form request. For now, what we are going to do, we are going to see how to write a code in process request. Okay, so till now what we have done, we have taken one new region, and under the new region we have taken four items. That items is related to the user ID and username and use responsibility ID and responsibility name. Now what we are going to do is we are going to display the values of those fields. Okay, to display the values, what we have to do is in process request we'll have to write a code. Okay, so first what we have to do, first for user ID, I am going to write a code. What we have to do, just I am going to take one variable. That is string, and going to be a user ID, equal to then string string here. Java is case sensitive. Is in string S should be capital letter. String string dot value of object. Object here is like the page contact. As I told you, like how we are going to see how to display the values taken from the page context and displaying in the page. Okay, so here page context dot get if you see like there is something syntax error, so that is the reason it is highlighted in red. So here the spelling is wrong. Context means text and get user ID. Okay. Yeah, first step we have taken one variable, and now to set a value, what we have to do is we'll have to create a object for that particular item. So for that, what we are going to use OA message text input bean. OA message text input bean. So to use this bean, actually we should have some package to be imported. Okay, that is framework web UI beans message dot OA message text input bean. So this is what the advantage of GUI developer. Whenever we are writing some syntax, so it will give us suggestions. Now to import this package, what we have to do is we'll have to click Alt Enter, then we can see the package. So we are going to select the first one. Yeah, so message bean, then we need to give some object, and then we'll have to take. So we message text input bean. Unfortunately, system is too slow. Web bean dot find child child recursive and the item. This maybe because of this it is very slow. Yeah, here we need to give the item which we are mapping this value. We are going to map this value to item 2. See something here we miss. Child recursive. Yeah. Next thing is we are going to assign a value to this object. Okay. So how to assign a value means MST dot. Set value and the page context is page context dot, and we are going to refer this variable value here. Okay, so now we have written a piece of code to display the value of user ID. So let's compile this and this is compiled successfully, and let's see the value what we are expected is going to be display or not. Guys, system is very slow. Maybe I'll try for the next session. Performance wise, it is very slow today. So till yesterday system was very very good. I don't know, suddenly it's taking too much time. Let's see. It is going to open the page. Yeah, so as we expected, we are able to see the user ID here. In the same way, using page context, how to display the remaining three fields values, we will see. Yeah, so here the same way, like how I have taken a variable, I am going to take the variable for remaining three items. Here I'm going to change this. My God, it's too slow. Yeah. So let's change. User ID to user name. Then your rest. ID and then rest name. So here we need to change this method to get the username. Get here. So to get the responsibility ID, we'll have to use a different method, that is get responsibility ID. Get responsibility ID. And to get the responsibility name, get responsibility name. So if you observe here, it is highlighted in red because here this is missing. Yeah, so we have taken the variables for different items to display the values, and now what we have to do is we'll have to bin to get the properties of these three items. And here we need to change the object name 1, 2, 3, and we'll have to change the items because we are going to display for the different items. So here it is 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so next we need to set the value to these items. So how to set the values is, I'm going to copy the user ID, set value, and here we need to change, instead of user ID, user name, resp ID, and resp name. So to see any syntactical errors or compilation errors, just right click. And rebuild. Yeah, it's compiling. Compiled successfully and no errors. Now let's see, let's run the page. Yeah, it's going to open the page. Yeah, so like it is displayed something instead of, yeah, see, if you see here, if you observe, finally it is displayed the responsibility in user ID. Okay, so because if you observe here, so we are assigning the value to the same object, okay, setting the value to the same object. So what we have to do, we'll have to change this object name, so whatever we are assigning. So let's change this and rerun it again. Yeah, I know guys, it is taking little time and I don't know why. So the system performance is very slow. I'll try to make it better for maybe the next sessions, coming sessions. We will see. I don't know, yeah. Yesterday it was good. Now suddenly its performance is not good. Very slow. Yeah, now we are able to see the user ID, username, responsibility ID and responsibility name. Yeah, we are done. As I told you in the starting of the session, so we have seen how to display the images in the page and how to change the logo. So in local when we are running the page in the local machine, and how to create an region and how to create a page and how to display the values in a page using page context, and how to work with the controller, what are the components, like if we see the controller will have process request and process form request. So we have written a piece of code so to display the values. Okay, so I hope you enjoy the session, and so I know it is having some slow, like the performance is very very slow. I'll try to do better in the next session. Thanks for watching video. Bye bye.